Confucianism. Confucianism is named for its founder, Confucius, who lived during a time of great turmoil in China. Confucius established a philosophy based on what he believed was the basic order of the universe. He stressed following traditional ways, which had worked well in the past to achieve peace and harmony. Confucius taught that each person should live up to his or her name, that is, fulfill their social obligations. Confucius placed great importance on traditional values such as obedience and order. He also stressed the importance of the family, where children should show devotion known as filial piety to their parents. For Confucius, the family served as a model for society, emphasizing duties, good deeds, and a civilized way of life. Let's look at the major beliefs of Confucianism graphic. Natural order. There is a natural order to the universe and to human relationships. Each person has a role in society, which reflects his or her position in the universe. Role of each person. Each person's social role brings a number of obligations. If everyone fulfills these roles by meeting their obligations, people and society will be in harmony. Relationships. In each relationship, there is a superior and an inferior. The superior must show love and responsibility, while the inferior must show loyalty and obedience. Mandate of heaven. If the ruler benefits his people and provides them with food and protection, then the people will obey their ruler, who will continue to hold the mandate of heaven, the right to rule. Taoism. Taoism, or Taoism, is a Chinese philosophy that began in the 5th century BC based on the teachings of Lao Tzu. Taoists believe that nature has a way, the Tao, in which it moves, and that people should accept the way of nature rather than try to resist it. Taoists have a deep respect for nature and harmony, and accept things rather than trying to change them. If you fight against nature, Taoists believe your action may even have results opposite to what you intended. People can achieve enlightenment only by non-striving, enjoying nature, and using contemplation to abandon earthly concerns. Creating a sharp contrast to Confucianism and Taoism was the third philosophical tradition of China's classical period, legalism. As the name suggests, the philosophy of legalism was less concerned with questions of the meaning of life and more with how people behaved. Since human nature was understood to be essentially bad, legalists believed that society needed a system of strict laws and punishments to control people. Because most citizens, according to legalism, should live their lives as either farmers or soldiers, education was not considered to be especially necessary. Legalists argued that society should discourage people from becoming teachers, merchants, poets, or artists. Another tenet of legalism was collective responsibility of a family or community for every member. One should observe one's relatives and neighbors and turn them into authorities if they break the law. Legalism was led by two philosophers, Han Fei and Li Zi. Their ideas struck a chord with many people during the often violent Qin dynasty. However, after the dynasty ended and the following dynasty brought greater stability, legalism faded. It failed to have the long-term impact of either Confucianism or Taoism.